angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, the Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy blessing to our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the mystery of the Gospel, so by his cross and passion that we come to know the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Drop down, ye heavens, from above, and let the skies pour down righteousness. Let the earth open and bring forth a Saviour. Let us pray. Most blessed light, who lighteth everyone that cometh into the world, bless us as we light these candles in preparation of thy coming, and so enkindle our hearts with the fire of thy love, that we may receive thee with joy and gladness, and hold thee fast with a firm faith.
Amen.
Our King and Saviour draweth nigh. O come, let us worship. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put on upon us the armour of light. Now in the time of this mortal life in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, now and for ever.
Amen.
Nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Introdora Davide in den glorifica in tutto man. Iuri camera in sedicione casa me de gente non santa ma nomen e nene quando vosso nome. Que tu estai un sudi con umano e cuore di polissi, cuore di sin cielo, con frigi venuti tu. E mette luce in tu per veritate, in tu mirse mette tu sero, in tu sero, ti monti un santo tuo, mette tu per l'altra natura. E ti introi con la tali, che nei tempi di chifica di uve tutto me. Quanti tempo ti vinci, tra Deus, 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 coi trisi d'anima mamma, e cuore con tuo verso me. Sfere in Deus, cuore, ma troppo che tei buchini, salutari vultus me, e Deus, Deus. Gloria Patri e Figlio, et Spiritus Sancto, sic ut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Introi volontari Dei, Dei qui nitifica in juventutum eum, auditori nostri Domini Domini, qui feci celum et terra. Confiti ut eum potente, via gloriosa Virgine, via eternità, via vita Christi, sancti posti, fecum farum, et in nomine Domini, nomine, et in sancti vobis fratris, via vita de minis crocifixioni, pecora propria, neo culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ele é o preco que me ata a Maria, o seu filho, e me dá uma cama, já me dá uma cama, e para que estão santos vossos, que eu vou falar. E a tua glória, Maria, e a minha mãe, santos vossos, cantais, orai por mim, e a minha mãe, nossa. Mas ele é o filho, que tens Deus, e tens ficado, e tens bruta, que é a vida, e a cama. Amém. Confite, ó Deus, onipotente, beata Maria, sempre virgine, beato Michele, arcangelo, beato Ioane Battista, e santos apóstolos, Herod, Paulo, Omnibus sanctis et divi pater, quia peccabilis cogitatione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Ideo preco beatam Mariam, sempre virginem, beatum Michaelum Arcangelum, beatum Ioannem Baptista, sanctus apostolos Petrum et Paulum, omnes sanctos, et te, Pater, orare pro me, ad hominem Deum nostrum. Miseriatum vestium, tu tens Deus, et missis peccatis vestis, quiduca cosa vita vetanam, Amen. Dulgens te assumpcione et omission in peccatorum nostrum et vivendo de qui soli potens misericordiamus. Amen.
Amen.
Deus tu conversas fortificabis nos, et
pleus tu
veritatis
omnium
te. Os tegni nobis Domini misericordiam tuam,
et salutari
cum da nobis. Domine exaudi reactione meam, et clamor meus et peribene. Dominus obiscum, et cum spiritu tuo, ore nos. Rorate Caeli Dei super et nubes pluent justum, aperiatur terra et gemine salvatorem. Caeli anerant gloriam Dei, et opera manium eius annuntia firmamentum. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Rorate Caeli Dei super et nubes pluent justum, aperiatur terra et gemine salvatorem. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Christe eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison. Dominus obiscum
et cum spiritu tuo.
Ore. Excita quaesumus Domine potentiam tuam et veni, et magna nobis vetute succurre, ut pro auxilium gratiae tuae, quod nostra peccata praevidunt, indulgentia tuae propitiationis accede. Vivibus et regnas cum Deo Pater in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, terram ia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordebus. Deus qui te beate varie vicini suter roverum tuum, angelo nunciante calem suscipare voluisti. Presta supplicibus tuis, ut qui per eam genitricem Dei credimus, eus ac ut intercessionibus adjuvemur. In ecclesiae tue quaesumus Domini fecis locatus admite, ut instruxis apprecisasibus et gloribus universis, secure tibi servi et debitate. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum Filium tuum, et ei condivita regna ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lex epistole piaci Pauli Apostoli ad Corinthios. Brethren, let a man so account us as servants of Christ and stewards of the mysteries of God. Now here it is required in stewards that a man be found trustworthy. But with me it is a very small matter to be judged by you or by man's tribunal. Nay, I do not even judge my own self, for I have nothing on my conscience. Yet I am not hereby justified, but he who judges me is the Lord. Therefore pass no judgment before the time until the Lord comes, who will both bring to light the things hidden in darkness and make manifest the counsels of hearts, and then everyone will have his praise from God.
Deo gratia.
Propria est omnius omnibus invocantibus eum, omnibus qui invocant eum veritate. Laudem Domini loquetoros meum, et benedicat omnes carum nomen sanctum eius. Alleluia, alleluia, veni Domini et noli tardare, relexa facinorda plebis tuae Israel. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum
et cum spiritu tuo,
sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Lucam.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
Now in the 15th year of the reign of Tiberius Caesar, when Pontius Pilate was procurator of Judea, and Herod, tetrarch of Galilee, and Philip his brother, tetrarch of the district of Iturea and Trachonitis, and Lysanias, tetrarch of Abilene, during the high priesthood of Annas and Caiaphas, the word of God came to John, the son of Zachary, in the desert. And he went into all the region about the Jordan, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins, as it is written in the book of the words of Isaiah the prophet, the voice of one crying in the desert, make ready the way of the Lord, make straight his paths. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be brought low, and the crooked way shall be made straight, and the rough way smooth, and all mankind shall see the salvation of God.
Laus tibi Christi.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii, Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast mass on this, the fourth Sunday of Advent. Drop down, ye heavens from above, and let the skies pour down righteousness. This was the introit for today's mass. Is the introit for the votive mass of Our Lady in Advent. It was the opening, it was the introit for last Ember Wednesday. We are in this mass in very many ways connecting yesterday's mass of Ember Saturday to the same, in the sense that it is the same gospel as yesterday that was read for the originally for the ordination of the sacred ministers that used to take place on Ember Saturday in Advent in Rome. We reflected on Ember Friday about the apostleship of Mary. We reflected last Ember Wednesday on the vocation of Mary. And yesterday on Ember Saturday, our thoughts were with those who were in beginning the sort of, as Churchill said, the beginning of the end. So they were accomplishing their vocations by their ordinations, but of course they were beginning their apostolic ministry. And so it is that this gospel speaks to us of that ministry. St. Luke, of course, places for us contextually the incarnation in the history of mankind. He does that deliberately to make the point. And indeed, this is the vast difference between our faith and that of all other world religions, is that our God indeed became one of us. Our God intervened deliberately in our timeline, in our chronology, so that we would always have a point to turn back to and to say that there was Emmanuel, God with us. Indeed, as the Venerable Fulton Sheen said, that in order for man to be lifted up, God himself had to come down. And that, of course, is the very nature and purpose of the Incarnation, that God became one of us. He humbled himself to share in our humanity that we might share in his divinity. And so it is in this process of divinization, of theosis, of sanctifying, that the newly ordained from yesterday to today began their apostolic ministry, their part, their share in the history of the salvation of mankind. As today they became voices, like Isaiah prophesied in the wilderness, they in turn become the new St. John the Baptist, seeking to bring the knowledge of the good news of salvation and of the presence of the Messiah into the lives of all God's people. Remember that as Isaiah prophesied, Micah and other prophets, the Messiah would not just be for the Jews, but would be for all peoples. The epistle today from St. Paul, his first letter to the Corinthians, reminds us, Holy Mother Church would remind us all, that we are all called to this process of divinization, of theosis, of sanctification, that we, all of us, should be moderate in our manners, should be compassionate and charitable in all our deeds, that we are all, though the ordained are particularly set apart for particular purposes, even so each and every one of us as a Christian is living out a vocation. Each and every one of us is called by God. And as we reflected much last week, each and every one of us is called to discern the particular vocation that God has implanted within us. Vocation, of course, comes from the Latin word vocare, and it means calling. A
And it is, my brothers and sisters, true that each and every person who comes into this world is given a vocation, has a vocation, is given a calling. We might say, from another perspective, that God is continually calling all those who are born into this world. He is calling them to discern his purpose, to apply themselves to his will, and in so doing, enable themselves to live life satisfactorily now and have it, enjoy eternal bliss with him forever. Drop down, drop down, ye heavens from above, and let the skies pour forth down righteousness. Now it is in this process of the incarnation that, of course, the heavens are opening and righteousness is coming down in the form of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But continually too, during this period of grace, during this generation from the ascension until the second coming, through the sacraments of the church, grace is continually, righteousness is continually being poured forth down from heaven upon us and upon those who would recognize and embrace it and enable it to change and convert their lives. Remember that as much as we are preparing for Christmas, we are of course also preparing for the end times. We are preparing ourselves for the judgment, for the coming judgment by the Messiah and his second coming. We, my brothers and sisters, during these last few days, approaching now the commemoration of the Nativity, ought to avail ourselves of these dewdrops of righteousness, of these of the possibility of grace and of righteousness that is afforded to us, particularly in the restorative sacraments of penance and of Eucharist. So that, whenever the Lord comes, and remember we do not know when that will be, but whenever the Lord comes, we will be found ready and waiting, watchful, and also too, of course, we will be continuing our process of divinization so that when we come to celebrate the great feast of the Nativity, we may do so unburdened by the cares of sin or disappointment, but rather be enlivened by God's grace to celebrate and enjoy Emmanuel, God with us. And of course, each time we avail ourselves of these sacraments, and particularly, of course, of the Eucharist, we behold that same incarnation. We behold the Word made flesh in order that we may feed upon him, in order that we may receive that eternal life that he promises those who feast upon him, who are ultimately invited to feast with him in heaven when his kingdom comes upon the earth. Let us, my brothers and sisters, then avail ourselves, as I say, of these restorative sacraments, so that this ongoing process of divinization, of theosis, may continue within us, that we may always be found ready and waiting, watchful and prepared for the Lord. Let us to avail ourselves of embracing God's calling, that each and every one of us has been given a unique vocation. As we celebrate those who have been ordained this Advent Ember, let us also remind ourselves of our own vocation, of our own calling. And if we have not yet discerned it, let us try, as we reflected last week on the feast during the Octave of the Conception, let us try, like the Blessed Virgin Mary, to live in holy fear, to live with the awareness that God is ever around us, and open our eyes and our hearts and our minds to the knowledge and promptings of the Holy Ghost, that we may discern his calling for us. In these ways too, let us then ourselves fulfill that general vocation which all of us possess as Christians, that of St. John the Baptist, that of the apostles, that of the sacred ministers and evangelists, and of all who have been baptized, to bring others to share in the joy of our redemption through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigns with God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Credo in unum Deum, Patrem omnipotentem, factorum caeli et terrae, visibilium omnium et invisibilium, et in unum Dominum Iesum Christum, Filium Dei unigenitum, et expansit antem ante omnia saecula, Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine, Deum verum de Deo vero, genitum non factum consustantia anem Patri, ecum omnia factus sum, qui prote nos homines et prote nosum salutem descendit de caelis, et ita natus est Spiritus Sancto ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Crucifixus est semper nobis supponsum Pilato passus et sepultus est, et resurrexit terce die secundus Scripturas, et descendit in caelum sedit dextram Patris, et iterum venturis est cum gloriae dicari vivos et mortuos, cuius veni non enit finis. Et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum et Vivificantem, qui ex Patri procedit, qui cum Patri et Filius semanator et tori cum glorificatur, qui locutus est per proprietas. Et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confitio unum baptismo et missionem perpetuorum, et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum, et vitam venturi saeculi. Amen. Dominus vobiscum, et cum spirito tuo. Oremus. Ave Maria, gratia plena Dominus tecum, benedicta tu in mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui. Orate fratres, nec vestum sacrificium acceptabile fit ad utem ad in omni potente. Suscipia Dominus sacrificium de malibus mortis. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum Spiritu Tuo,
sus in corda,
habemus ad Domino.
Gratias damus, Domino Deo nostro, dignum et justum est. Vere dignum et justum est ecum salutare di nostri bisempere gruppi per gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater Onnipotens et Fene Deus. Qui cum unigenito Filio Tuo, Spiritu Sanctum, unus est Deus, unus est Dominus, non in unius in glavitate et persona, sed in unius trinitate substantia. Padre in te tua gloria, velante te credimus, hoc de Filio Tuo, hoc de Spiritu Sancto, sine deferenze e anet expressioni sentimus. Ultic versione, veris avuterai quod et adis, et de personis proprietas, et in essentia unicas, et in maestate doretur qualitas. Quam laudant angelia tua et angeli cherubim quoque et serfim, qui non cessit lumare quod videre, una voce dicet.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus,
Dominus Deus Sanctus, venis in Caeli et Terra, Gloria Tua, Hosanna in Excelsis. Benedictus vi venit in Domine Domini, Hosanna in Excelsis. Novus Corpus Peccatorius. Erongia secula seculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, prece qui salutalibus malici divinis et luciare formati, ad Deus dice. Pater noster qui es in cieli, sanctificetur nomen tuum, ad veniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, se libra nostra malia. Per omnia secula seculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum. Et cum spirito tuo. Agnus Dei, qui codis peccato mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui codis peccato mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui codis peccato mundi, condona nobis pace. Domine non sunt dignus. Domine non sunt dignus. Domine non sunt dignus. Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi. Domine non sunt dignus, ut in censo tectum meo, sed tantum declerbo, et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sunt dignus, ut in censo tectum meo, sed tantum declerbo, et senabitur anima mea. Domine non sunt dignus, ut in censo tectum meo, sed tantum declerbo, et senabitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion, the words for which you will find below your viewing screen.
My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen.
Ecce Virgo concipiet, et parve filium, et vocabitur nomen eius, Immanuel. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo.
Oremus. Sum sis mulieribus coesimus Domine, ut cum frequentatione mysterii, fresiat nostri salutis effectus. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus. Gratiam tuam coesimus Domine mensibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelum nuntiante Christi fili tui in paraxione cognotimus, per passionem eius et crucem et resurrectionis gloriam reducamus. Quaesimus Domine Deus nostri, ut quos divine tribuis participatione cadere, cum benedicat sine sorceri periculis. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spirito tuo,
benedicamus Domino.
Deo gratias.
In nomine Domini benedictum ex hoc loco tuusque et saecula, aut ut orbem nostrum in nomine Domini qui feci caelum et terram. Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
In Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat apud Deum, et Deus erat verbum, hoc erat in principio apud Deum. Omnia per ipsum factus sunt, et simsum factum est nihil quo factum est. In ipsum vita erat lus hominum, et lus in tenebris lucere, et tenebris non comprehenderum. Quid homo messus Deo qui nomine erat Ioanne, et sic venit in testimoni, mu testimoni bibere tu lumine, et omnescendum primum. Non erit ille lux, erat testimoni bibere tu lumine, erat lux vere, qua luminat omnem hominem venientem in hoc mundum. In mundum erat, in munus ruxum factus est, in munus in non coniovit, in proprio venitit sum non in ceperum. Quod quod autem ceperum Deum Dei deris forestatim filios Deo fieritis, qui plent in omni eus, qui non est aquinibus, necus mutati carnis, necus mutati viris, ric Deo natis. Et verbum carno factum est. Et habitavit in nobis et virimus gloria, minus gloria, in quasi unigenitio pati, per gratia et veritatis.
Deo gratias.
God save Elizabeth our Queen, and graciously hear us when we call upon thee. Let us pray. Almighty God, we pray for thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, upon whom thy mercy has laid the government of this kingdom. May she be given so great a measure of every virtue, thus worthily adorned, may she turn aside from all wickedness, may she overcome her enemies and with her consort and the royal family, may she come at last in grace to thee, the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the divine assistance remain with us always. May the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace and rise with Christ in glory. Amen. May our heavenly patron, Saints Cuthbert and Wilfrid,
pray for us.
May St. Louina, Virgin Martyr of Sussex,
pray for us.
May Our Lady, Queen of Heaven, all the angels and saints,
pray for us.